friends! Okay, so this past Sunday, June 26th, I went to the second and last day of IMAP. I don't plan on taking it off. I plan on letting it fall off. Maybe I'm a dork, but I think it's fine. I'm gonna show you what I bought and like people I saw and that sort of stuff. So let's get into it. When I first got in, like the lines were very long and all that junk. But it only took me about like couple of minutes to get in. It wasn't that bad. When I first got in, the first booth that I saw was the LA Splash booth. And they were having, like, you know, everybody there was having sales, discount sales, that sort of thing. And I bought glitters and a eyeshadow sealer base thing for the glitter. they were, the smaller ones were $5 for $25, and then the bigger ones were $5 for $30, I believe. So I bought this one. Is in black and it is called Rockstar. This one is in silver and it is called Silver Torpedo. This one is like a turquoise color and oddly enough it is called Tropical Lime. I don't know, I don't make the names. This one is gold and it's called Pacific Sand. And this one is purple, and it is called Purple Passion. Okay, and then I bought this LA Splash Splash Proof Sealer, Eyeshadow Sealer, and Base for the glitter. I had like swatched it on my hand and then put the purple glitter over it, and the purple glitter stayed all day. So I was very happy with that. The next thing that I bought personally were these brushes at the Crown Brush booth. That booth was crazy. Like there was like a buffet top like style like brush layout, but everybody was over there. Like it was a huge booth and there was a huge line. So I bought these brushes. I bought a brush roll that came with a bunch of different face and eye brushes, and then this brush right here. This didn't come in it, but I'm not a fan of fan brushes, so I just took it out. This one was actually a Sigma brush. They weren't selling anything, but they had a booth, and they were giving away just like a little sample. So this one is a Sigma Blending E25, and I just stuck that in there. They're all silver, so I'm pretty glad that they match. And then brush roll rolled up. Okay, and then the next thing I bought were these Violent Lips temporary lip tattoos. Just like that, as you see, those are the ones I bought, and then they gave me random swag. But these are actually pretty cool. I think they come 3 in a pack, and they're just like any other press-on tattoo. Those girls were really nice, and they were wearing them, and they wore them all day. That was pretty sweet. And then somebody just handed me this. I think I might put it on my car if my boyfriend lets me. But I think that's way cute. I went by the Inglot booth and I was going to buy a palette, but the line was wrapped around like the whole section. That was also like a buffet style sort of thing, but you got a clipboard and you got to like write down the colors you wanted and then you handed them to the people and they would make your palette. But that took, I think, like half an hour was the last time I heard. But I was there alone, and I wanted to go get what I wanted, look at everything, see what I wanted, and then leave. I didn't want to wait for anything. So no offense against Inglot, but it was bananas. Who else was there? Sugar Pill, OCC, MAC. MAC was even more ridiculous. They looked really unorganized, so I went over there like once, asked about something, and left. Like, I didn't even bother waiting in line, I didn't even bother looking at the makeup. I just asked if they had something, they told me no, and they left. That was it. I don't really bother going to MAC at those sort of things because I live so close to numerous MAC stores that it's not really a problem to get anything. There were also, like, hair booths there. There were also different, like, special effects stuff was there. That was really cool. I bought this hair extension. I think it's cute. At the Crown Brush booth, there were, this made me really excited, the people from Face Off. Like the winner, Connor was there, and he was doing that like annoying girl, I don't even know her name, but he did her makeup and she looked like a dog and she had a top hat and he was really cool. I got a picture with him and I talked to him. And then Frank was there and he was really cool. He was a funny guy. Like I was freaking out and he was like, whoa, whoa, calm down, chill out. But he was really cool, so I got a picture with him. And then the judge, what's his name? Glenn Petrick. That one. That's his name. He's a judge for them, and then he does like all the special effects makeup for like heroes and a couple of other stuff. But he was there, and I got a picture with him, and he was really cool. Then like I was waiting for my favorite gurus to get there, so as I was waiting, I stopped by the Yabby booth. And I've never heard of Yabby before, but they had some really cute colors, and I noticed they had a bunch of different palettes. So I stopped by, I talked to them, and they said that you could buy the palettes like pre-made, or you could buy an empty palette and put the stuff you wanted in it. And their palettes were $14, and then their eyeshadows were 2 for $5, and their blushes were $8. So I went ahead and I bought an empty palette, and I just put random stuff in it. This one, I bought 4 different colors. They're all shimmer colors. This one is purple, and it is called Fairy Princess. This one is like a misty, it's like a blue with like a gold shine. This one is called Jungle Mist. It's more of a green with a gold shine. This one is a blue with the gold shine, like a navy blue with the gold shine. And it's midnight blue. And then this one is a shimmery navy blue. And when I got home, I realized I already have like a million shimmery navy blues. But this one really caught my eye because it's very well pigmented and it's smooth and I like it a lot. This one is called Butterfly Blue. And then I bought a blush. If I can take it out, let's see. There we go. Hot blush. This one is in BL019 blush. And that's what my palette looks like. I have my Sephora concealer in there, but you can fill up the palette. Okay. Then what else? Oh, then I heard. Like, I tweeted Jazzy Baby Cakes on when she was coming, and she was like, I'm here now! So I freaked out, guys. She's my favorite person, like, my favorite guru ever. Like, I just love her. So, the first person that I took a picture with was Petrolude, and he was actually in drag as Misty Maven. Oh my god, he is beautiful. Like, he's completely flawless, he's beautiful, and he's, like, tall, and he's awesome. He was at the Obsessive Compulsive Cosmetics booth, OCC, and he was wearing his OCC shirt, and I went over there, I was like, oh my god, can I take a picture with you? And he was like, ah, yeah. And then, like, we took a picture, and, like, one of the guys from the OCC booth took it for us. I was super excited, and then I ran back to Sugar Pill, and I saw Lauren, and then I wanted to buy a palette, and I was like, I'm right here. So I kind of cut in front of the other, like, everybody else in line, but I knew what I wanted, and they pointed at it, and the girl was like, okay. So I bought this Sugar Pill palette. It says Addicted to Pretty. The colors inside, the pink one is Dolly Pop, the blue one is After Party, the green one is Midori, and the white one is Taco. I was really excited. I've been wanting one of these for a long time. So I bought it, and then I turned around and Lauren was gone, but I found Jazzy Baby Cakes, and I was like, oh my god, you're Jazzy Baby Cakes, and oh my god, you're my favorite, and she was like, oh, calm down, look, can I hug you, and I was like, oh my god, you can hug me, oh my god, so I hugged her, and we hugged, and I was so excited, and then we took a picture, was like, oh, give me another hug. I was like, oh my god. So I hugged her again and I freaked out. And she probably thought I was a weirdo, but yeah, I was really excited. And then I put up her picture. I put up her picture like of us on Facebook. And she was like, I was like, oh my god, I hugged my favorite guru. And she commented on my picture and said, if I ever see you again, I'm gonna hug you two more times. I was like, oh my god, and I freaked out. I'm sorry, she's my favorite. But then I was ready to go, because I got the stuff I wanted, and I saw the people I wanted. And then on my way out, I ran into XSparkage and MacNC40, who were also really amazing. I was like, oh my god! Again, and I took a picture with them, and it was just really exciting. So overall, my first IMAX experience was killer. Like, I loved it. I'm gonna go next year and try to go both days and save more money, because this time I spent like $50 over my limit. So I spent like $150. But I'm gonna save more money, go both days, catch a couple of the classes, because this time I only had an exhibit floor pass, but if you can get like to the classes into like the main hall. I know a bunch more people were there. Pris Buzz was there. Encore Makeup was there. Candy Johnson was there. She had a class, but I didn't catch it. But yeah, so if you ever have a chance to go to IMAX, be it LA or New York or like Australia or London or any of that, go. They're fun. You learn a lot. You see a lot. You meet a bunch of really cool people. It's a great experience. Just go. Do something different. Yeah, so that was my IMAX experience. Sorry if I rambled on. But stay tuned for more tutorials. Thank you for watching and have a good day.